Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss the superposition theorem. So this theorem name itself is telling superposition. The name itself is telling superposition. The reason is we are superpose or algebraically adding the voltage across or current through the branch due to each individual source acting alone to obtain the total current or voltage across a circuit element. What does it mean? So superposition. Superposition means we are superposing. We are taking one source at a time and using that source we will find what is the response across a particular element. That response can be either a voltage or a current. That means current through that element or voltage across the element. What is asked in the numerical? So each source we will check separately, then we will take the algebraic sum of the effect due to all the sources. So or each individual sources. So that's why it is called as superposition theorem. So this theorem is applicable only for the linear. The linear means the active and passive elements with independent sources. That means this is only applicable if your circuit is containing only active and passive elements with independent sources only. If there are dependent sources, then you cannot apply the superposition theorem. You have to go for other theorems only. Superposition theorem cannot be applied if there are dependent sources or nonlinear elements in the circuit. And this is applicable also only for the bilateral networks. So then the statement of superposition theorem is, in a linear bilateral DC network containing more than one energy source, the resultant potential difference across or the current through any element is equal to the algebraic sum of the potential differences or current through that element produced by each source acting alone with all other independent sources replaced by their internal resistances. So what we have to do, we have to take one source at a time, replace all the remaining sources by their internal resistances and find the response at a particular branch. That means the response can be either voltage or the current. Then once you obtain the response because of each individual voltages, you have to take the sum. So I am again summarizing that in the form of the procedure. The procedure is, first we have to select one source in the circuit and replace all other ideal voltage sources by short circuit and all ideal current sources by open circuit. So once this is done, determine the voltage across or current through the desired element or branch due to single source selected in step 1. That means for a source selected in step 1, we have to find the response. Then we have to repeat the above two steps. That means step number 1 and step number 2 for each and every source. So we get the response. Let us assume there are 3 sources. We get 3 responses. Response because of the first one, due to second one and due to third one. So after that, what you have to do? Algebraically add all the voltage across or current through the element under consideration, because voltage across or current through is the response. This sum is actual voltage across or current through that element when all the sources are acting simultaneously. So reading all the theory, all these things may be a little confusing. Let us take one example and try to solve it so that whatever I am telling will be clear to you. So I am taking one numerical. Use superposition theorem to find the current I in the circuit where all the resistors are in ohms. So this is the circuit given. So here the current is missing. So I am just writing this. Let us assume this current is 120 amperes. So in this circuit, it is asked to find the value of the current I. So for this, what I have to do? So we have just discussed that the step number one. Step number one, you have to take one source at a time and find the response. What is the response I want? I want the current passing at this point. So I have to want to find the current across this point. So let us keep some numbering of the nodes so that it will be easy. Let us assume this node is A, this node is B. This node is A and second node is B. I want the current that is passing from node A to node B. So let us take one source at a time. So there are 3 sources. So there will be 3 steps. So first I am taking the 120 ampere source. So if you take the 120 ampere source, so I am just drawing the circuit here only. So this 120 ampere source is as it is. Across this there is 50 ohms. This is my node B, this is my node A. So here one more current resistance is there, 150. So now coming to the voltage and current sources. This voltage should be replaced by their internal resistance. As no internal resistance is mentioned for this resistance voltage source, so ideally it will be equal to 0. The internal resistance is 0. Similarly, internal resistance of a current source will be infinite, or it should be taken as open circuit. So I have taken the open circuit of this. So now I want to calculate what is this current. I want to calculate what is this current. So, but you can see the current 120 amperes is coming like this. Out of this, some current will divide here, some current will divide here. So let us take this current as I1. See here that I1 is opposite to I. So I can calculate the value of I1. So the calculate the value of I1, I1 is equal to 120 into other resistance by total resistance. Because there are two parallel resistors, the current is dividing among that. So other resistance is 50 divided by total resistance is 50 plus 150. This becomes 200. So if you calculate this, you will get this as 30 amperes. So you remember here, this is the current passing from B to A, but I want the current passing from A to B. So I want the current passing from A to B will be equal to minus I1. So this will be equal to minus 30 amperes. This is because of one source. So similarly, we have to take for other sources. Let us take the case of the second source. Second source means I am just taking the source of 10 volts. So if I take the source of 10 volts, so 10 volts plus minus, these are my resistors, this is 50 and this value is 150. So this current sources will be replaced by their ideal resistances. Ideal value means infinite. This is my branch AB. I want to calculate this current. So now because of this voltage source, let us assume my current is coming like this. So the same current will pass and return back. That means it is a series circuit only. So I can calculate my value of the current from this. The value of the current I can calculate from A to B will be equal to 10 divided by the total resistance. Total resistance is 150 plus 50 is 200. Everyone agree with me? So this becomes 0.05 amperes. So let us take this as equation number 2. So now take the third source. So the third source means I am only taking the 40 ampere source. So remaining voltage source is replaced by short circuit. There is 50 ohms. There is 150 ohms. The first current source is replaced by internal resistance. Internal resistance means infinite. So this is my A, this is my B. I want this current. So third current source is acting. This current source is 40 amperes. We know the current source, the current will come like this. The current will divide among these two. So I can calculate my current. So current through this A to B. So I A to B, I can calculate as the total current multiplied by other resistance into total resistance. So other resistance is 150 divided by total resistance is 50 plus 150. So if you calculate this, you will get this value as 30 amperes. This is my equation number 3. So now the actual current when all the sources are applied together will be sum of the current passing because of each source from A to B. So I A to B due to source 1, then I A to B due to source 2, then I A to B due to source 3 acting alone. So you can take the sum because of source 1 is minus 30. Because of source 2, we got 0.05. And because of the third source, we got 30. So this becomes 0.05 amperes. So the current through that element is 0.05 amperes. You can see we got it as plus. The plus means whatever the direction is given, in that direction only the current is passing. If you get minus, we have to tell the current value is 0.05 passing in the opposite direction. That means passing from B to A. Or we can tell that minus 0.05 amperes passing from A to B. In that way we have to tell. So if it is opposite. In this case, we got plus only, so there is no issue. So let us try to take one more example so that to further clarify what we have discussed. So till now we have derived the current through an element. So how to decide the response, that means voltage across a particular branch or element. So next example is using superposition theorem, find the value of output voltage V0 in the circuit. So it is asked to find the V0 across two terminals A and B in this circuit. So again here how many sources are there? Total there are three sources. So we have to write three equations, so or three responses. So first I am finding the response only with 6 ampere source. So only 6 ampere source is here. This is 1 ohms. This is 3 ohms. This current source will be replaced by open circuit. This is 2 ohms. This voltage source will be replaced by short circuit. This is my terminal A, this is terminal B. I want across this voltage. That means I want VA minus VB or VAB I want. So in order to find this, you can see here out of the 6 amperes coming here, some current will pass like this and some current will divide in this. Let us assume this current is equal to I1. So I can calculate the current I1. So
let us try to calculate here only. So the current I1 will be equal to this 6 into other resistance divided by total resistance. Total resistance is 1 plus 3 plus 2. So 3 plus 3 is 6, so we get it as 1 ampere. So what will be the voltage V0? I can calculate my voltage V0 is equal to this current will pass like this. This is my value of the current I1. So when the current I1 is passing, automatically voltage drop will be plus minus. That means in the same direction. So the output voltage V0 will be equal to 2 into 1 ampere. This will be equal to 2 volts. This will be equal to 2 volts. So let us take this as equation number 1. So this is V0 because of the first source. Let us take the second source. Second source means I am taking the current source of 4 amperes. So automatically 6 amperes is open circuit. 3 ohms, 2 ohms and 6 volts is replaced by short circuit. This is my terminal A and B. I want the voltage across this plus minus. And here there is a current source. This is 4 amperes. Now you can see here again 4 amperes is coming here. It will divide among two paths. One path is this one, another path is this one. Let us take this path as I2. I want to check what is the current passing through 2 ohms resistor. Again same thing, this value of I2 I can obtain as I into I is 4 into other resistance. Other resistance will be 3 ohms divided by total resistance is 3 plus 3. You can see here this 2 ohms and 1 ohm are connected in series because this is one path. This is my second path. So this will become 4 divided by 2. So you get it as 2 amperes. So if this is 2 amperes, I can calculate my value of V0 with the second source will be equal to 2 into 2, which is equal to 4 volts. Let us take this as equation number 2. So now I am taking the only third source. Third source means the first source is replaced by open circuit. And second source also replaced by open circuit. And now only the third source is there. So this third source is having minus plus 6 volts. This is what is coming. So I want to calculate the voltage at this point. This is my V0. I want the voltage across VAB. So let us see, because of this voltage source, because this is plus, automatically this produces some current I. That current will pass through this. So first I can calculate this current. So let us take this current as I3. I can calculate my current I3 is equal to 6 divided by 6. So I will get it as 1 ampere. So this 1 ampere when it is passing, so 1 ampere will pass like this. So automatically voltage drop across this 2 ohms will be like this. So if you want to calculate the voltage, if you want to calculate the voltage, I can calculate the voltage between A and B. So between A and B, if you write the equation, so I can write that VA, because at point A, I am assuming it as plus, minus, I am going from plus to minus. So I am going from positive to negative, so this becomes minus 2. Plus, I am going from minus to plus here for the voltage source. So automatically this becomes plus 6 is equal to voltage at point B. So if I want to calculate the voltage at point B with respect to A, so this will be equal to VA, voltage at A, minus the drop. The drop is equal to 2 volts. There is a drop in the resistor and there is a gain of 6 volts in the battery. So otherwise from this equation, I can write VA minus VB is equal to VA minus VB is equal to, this will go to the second side. So you will get it as minus 4 volts. VA minus VB is minus 4 volts. So we got all the three voltages. So you want the total response. Total response is response because of the first source plus response because of the second source plus response because of the third source. Because of the third source, this is the response. So if you take the sum will be equal to 2 plus 4 minus 4. So this will become equal to 2 volts. I hope this superposition theorem is clear to you. So next class we are going to discuss what is the Thevenin's and the Norton's theorem. So if you still have any queries related to this topic, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. And while solving the numericals, if you face any problem or if you want me to solve something or provide you some material or something, so you can leave a mail to my email ID. My email ID is ktrajuiitr@gmail.com. I am repeating again, my email ID is ktrajuiitr@ gmail.com. So I will respond to your queries directly to your mail, or if you have small queries, you can leave in the comment section below. I will respond from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.